Module number one. In this module, we will be discuss about the atomic structure. For atomic structure, to understand atomic structure, we must know about the number one, position of electrons, protons, and neutrons in an atom. Number two, nuclear and extranuclear part of an atom. Number three, we understand the shells and subshells and presence of subshells in a shell. We also know, must we understand about the maximum accommodation of electrons within a shell. And number six, types of subshells, their names with capacity. Now, what is atomic structure? Atoms are the basic unit of matter. Position of electrons, protons, and neutrons in an atom. Observe the diagram, in which each fundamental particle is represented by different colors. Atoms are made up of extremely tiny particles called protons, neutrons, and electrons. Protons and neutrons are in the center of the atom, making up the nucleus. Electrons around the nucleus. Protons have a positive charge. Electrons have a negative charge. The charge on the proton and electron are exactly the same size, but opposite. Neutrons have no charge. Nuclear and extranuclear part of an atom. Observe the diagram. You observe that proton and neutron present inside the nucleus and electron revolve around the nucleus. So we can say that the nucleus of the atom contains the proton and neutrons. The outermost region of the atom are called electron shells and contain the electrons. Since opposite charges attract protons and electrons attract each other, atoms have different properties based on the arrangement and number of their basic particles. Observe the diagram, shells and subshells. To understand electronic configuration, we must know about shells and subshells. Here we observe that there's number of shells present around the nucleus. The shell which is next to the nucleus having number one is known as shell number one, and number two, three, and so on. The shell which is nearer to the nucleus having low energy shell, and shell which is far from the nucleus are high energy shell. Each shell represents the number of subshell. If shell is one, there is only one subshell, that is 1s. If shell is 2, they having 2 subshell, 2s and 2p. If shell is 3, they having 3 subshell, 3s, 3p, 3g. If shell is 4, they having 4 subshell, 4s, 4p, 4d and 5f. And rest of the shells having the same number of subshells, that is 5s, 5p, 5g, 5f, 6s, 6p, 6d, 6f and so on. So we can know what is the shell. We must know what is the shell. Observe both the diagram. You observe the number of shell represented by a letter. Shell is the outer part, outside part of an atom around the nucleus. The electron revolve around the nucleus in different energy levels or shells according to their respective energies. Energy levels are represented by n values, 1, 2, 3 and so on. They are designated by the alphabets K, L, M and so on. A shell closer to the nucleus is of minimum energy. What are subshells? Observe the diagram. If shell is 1, only 1 subshell. If shell is 2, 2 subshell. If shell is 3, 3 subshell. And shell is 4, 4 subshell and so on. A shell or energy level is subdivided into subshells or sub-energy level. N values of a shell is placed before the symbol for a subshell. The N number determines how many of the subshells make up the shell. For example, the first shell K is made up of one subshell, that is 1s. The second shell L is made up of two subshell, 2s and 2p. Third shell M shell is made up of three subshell, 3s, 3p and 3d. And the fourth shell N is made up of four subshell, 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f and so on. presence of subshells in a shell. Observe the diagram. This represent here, we represent the four types of subshell: S orbital, P orbital, G orbital, and F orbital. Electrons orbit the nucleus of an atom at the different ranges called shells. Each shell has a different energy level, increasing the further it is from the nucleus. Each energy level is given a number called the principal quantum number, that is represented by small n. The n number determines how many of the subshells make up the shell. Maximum accommodation of electron. Observe this table. Here we have formula 2n square. N is the quantum number designated by 1, 2, 3 and so on. It is represented by the shell. If n is 1, there's 2 electron accommodating first shell. If n is 2, second shell, there's 8 number of electron can accommodate over there. 2 to the 4th and n is the number of shell. 2 to the 4th. And 4 multiplied by 2. In third shell, 18 electron can be accommodated. In fourth shell, 32 electron accommodate. This formula is not reliable for higher energy level shell. Okay, each shell can contain only a fixed number of electrons. The first shell can hold up the 2 electrons. The second shell can hold up the 8 electrons, 2 in S and 3 in P. The third shell can hold up to 18 electrons, 2 in S, 6 in P and 10 in D and so on. The general formula is that the N shell can be principal hold up to 2N square electron. But actually K contains 2 electrons, L contains 8 electrons, M contains 8 electrons, N and O contains 18 electrons, P contains 32 and Q contains 32. Types of subshell and their capacity. Observe the diagram. Here we represented 4 blocks of the periodic table: S block, P block, D block, and F block. S having maximum capacity 2, P having maximum capacity 6, D having maximum capacity 10, and F having maximum capacity 14. There are 4 subshells, S, P, G, and F. Each subshell can hold a different number of electrons. The N number determines how many of the subshells make up the shell. S is equal to 2 electron, P having maximum accommodation of 6 electron, D having maximum capacity 10 electron, and F having maximum capacity 14 electron. Okay. Thank you. Now module 1 is completed.